Hi, you're here with Con, the CEO of the ASRC, and I want to show you today our home of hope. I want to show you especially how we've navigated through this COVID-19 pandemic. One of the most important things we did to begin with is we've kept our doors open from day one. When many charities had to understandably close their doors, we knew how important it was for people seeking asylum to still be able to physically come in crisis to get food, housing, medicine, and aid. Let me show you through. So we're here at front reception, and this is the first place of contact when people come in. And during the COVID-19 pandemic, the smiling faces of our staff and volunteers have often been the only social contact and connection people have had. Usually behind us, you'll see the centre bustling on a normal ASRC day. But right now, when we're trying to keep our staff, volunteers and members safe and social distancing in place, we're not asking people to sit around and have their meal or hang out. We want to keep people safe while getting the essential supports that they need. Come follow me through. You're in the ASRC supermarket now, and usually what you would see is a mini supermarket where people get to choose their own food for the week. But during the pandemic, the key challenge for us was how do we give people food security while keeping everyone safe? So we pivoted and innovated to emergency food parcels. So people are able to come in, pick up and go with the food they need for their families, nutritious, healthy and culturally inclusive. And since the pandemic began, 3,781 of these life-saving packs have been given to people either turning up, and we're now also delivering to our most vulnerable people contactless straight to their doorstep. The power of your support. So COVID-19 created another massive challenge for us. Over here, usually every day at lunchtime, more than 200 people sit to have a hot meal together. It's part of the heart of this organization, but impossible during a pandemic. But we still need to make sure people had a hot meal, often their only one for the day. So what do? We redeployed our catering team, asylum seekers that we were employing that suddenly had no work, and got them instead to make hundreds of beautiful, delicious meals every day to keep families free of hunger. That's our innovation yet again. When a person seeking asylum comes to the ASRC for the very first time, they come to new presentations, which is where I'm standing right now. And they see our frontline social workers, who in the month of April saw almost as many people as they see usually in a 6-month period. That has been the catastrophic impact of COVID-19 on the lives of people seeking asylum. Our social workers are our first responders. In each of these intake rooms, they are in there helping people find that safe night of accommodation, making sure we can link them up to critical medical care, lawyers, help finding work. They are very much that lifeline, that bridge to help people rebuild their shattered lives during this pandemic. So what do? If you have no income and no Medicare during a pandemic? You turn to the ASRC. This is our health program. In the month of April alone, we provided pharmacy waivers for 140 people who otherwise would have no medicine. 608 appointments in April alone, and 240 people were immunized out in that drop-in space you saw just before to make sure they were safe as winter comes. In fact, this week, we're now going out to people over 65 and immunizing them in their homes to keep them even more safe. Come on through here. This is one of our regular GP rooms, and we've been running face-to-face GP clinics as well as telemedicine, telepsychiatry, telenursing clinics as well. This perfect hybrid model that's been able to keep people safe right when healthcare is more critical than ever for people without Medicare and without income. Our amazing nurses and doctors have found a way to keep people safe. Let's go visit our human rights law program. Come on through. Our human rights law program. No, Peter Dutton hasn't suddenly given everyone seeking asylum and done the right thing. And that's why our lawyers aren't here. In fact, our lawyers are doing an incredible job, but they're doing it safely from their homes. We have such a huge team of legal volunteers and such an incredible team of lawyers. It was impossible during a pandemic for them to operate safely here while social distancing. And in fact, right now we've got 74 wonderful volunteers working with our lawyers, running all our clinics as usual, from our gender clinic to our Wednesday night legal clinic, even to our La Trobe University clinic. And they are helping hundreds and hundreds of people seeking asylum and are seeing seeing an unprecedented demand for people in need of legal assistance, and they're doing a terrific job, again, innovating by providing a tele-legal service. We're in front of our innovation hub, the place where we help people seeking asylum find their first job in this country or get into TAFE. It's been hard hit because of this pandemic. In fact, 271 people either lost their job or had their hours significantly cut because of this pandemic and because of no access to JobKeeper. So we've been busily innovating yet again, keeping connected to 600 job-ready asylum seekers through using Slack. We've also been creating assets for the TAFE sector to keep asylum seekers engaged and been finding all sorts of innovative and creative ways of bridging the digital divide to help our peoples get job ready and be ready when recovery comes.